Hello all, my name is Andrus, I'm a head of LABA7 and I'm also head of LABA7 engineering department. Today I would like to tell you a little bit about our new device called EMA, which stands for Electromagnetic Linear Shock Dyno. So what's special about our EMA, about LABA7 EMA? The machine itself was all designed and developed in-house. What does it mean? From the ground up, everything was done here with precision and innovation in mind. First of all, it's a control unit and data logger are all developed and manufactured here with idea to have the best resolution and highest possible speed of reading the data from the sensors which measures the data from shock absorbers. The mechanics are made in the way to minimize the moving mass and vibrations. It helps to ensure superior testing accuracy. What truly sets us apart from the competitors, it's firmware that was written from the scratch here in our department, focusing on control and safety. Another thing that will help to revolutionize usage of EMA is our smart power supply. For now, using EMA, you needed a high input power from the mains. With our power supply, you will be able to run EMA from standard mains power supply. What's that special about smart power supply? The smart power supply unit of the LABA7 machine is a game changer in how we approach power needs. While the larger EMA version will still require three-phase 16 amps connection, the smallest model can operate from the standard 220 outlet, which means you can run it in the racetracks or in the race trucks. This innovation opens up new possibilities, allowing any suspension workshop to own and utilize an EMA for the first time. Previously, running an electromagnetic machine required very high power inputs. Now, for the smallest models, you can simply plug it into regular power outlet and start running tests. Essentially, this advancement means you no longer need your personal power plant and you can operate electromagnetic shock dyno from the standard mains. So, LABA7 data logger in EMA. The LABA7 data logger is a marvel in its own right, developed in-house with the capability to detect the smallest and lightest force changes in the shock absorbers. It boasts an impressive position resolution and sampling rate of 50 nanometers at 20 kHz speed digitally. The load cell resolution and sampling rate are equally impressive at 20 bits, 20 kHz speed. Not to mention its temperature sampling, analog output and input channels are designed for the precision and flexibility, with interfaces ranging from Ethernet to Wi-Fi and HDMI to USB, it's equipped for any modern application. This level of detail ensures unparalleled accuracy and reliability in data collection. So what is the difference between Scotch yoke dynos and electromagnetic linear dynos that we do? In comparing the technologies, it's crucial to know that neither EMA nor Scotch yoke dynos are inherently better or worse. They serve different purposes. The EMA is primarily aimed at performance testing and ultra-fine tuning of the dampers, providing the precision needed for the most critical stages of development. Meantime, the Scotch yoke dynos excel in reliability and quality assurance testing. While a Scotch yoke dyno can handle about maybe 70% of the daily work, for the last 30% of the development, which needs ultra-precise adjustment and detailed performance testing, there is no substitute for an electromagnetic shock dyno done by LABA7. Thank you for watching, that's it for today. You can find more information on laba7.com or our Instagram or Facebook pages. Follow us and see the latest news.